Hello everybody, welcome to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. I hope you are all good. Today our topic is relay coordination. Okay, so in our earlier one of video we have discussed about the setting of relay, but in this video we will discuss that how the relays are coordinated. Now what is coordination? Coordination means a time-graded sequential operation. That is, suppose if there is any fault at this switchgear bus, then first this relay will be operated, then this relay will be operated, then this relay will be operated. So this time-graded operation is called the coordination. Okay, so in this video we will only focus on the overcurrent and earth fault relay coordination. The other relays are not generally required coordination. So let's see how the settings are done and how the coordinations are achieved. So let's start this video. Now see, this is a simple power system for which we will check the relay coordination. Suppose this system is getting fed from 132 kV. It is falling on a 132 kV bus. Then there are two transformer of 132 by 6.9 kV, 30 MVA suppose. So this is the 6.6 kV switchgear bus, and from there one 6.6 kV motor is running, and further this 6.6 kV is stepping down to 415 volt by a 2.5 MVA transformer, and it is feeding a 415 volt switchgear. Okay, from here one motor is running and another two feeder is going to another MCC which is driving some other motors. So suppose this is the basic our power system, and we have to check the relay coordination. Now remember one thing, it is the most important tips for relay coordination. Whenever you have to check coordination of any power system relays, then you have to check the coordination with respect to the longest path. Okay, remember the longest path. See, I have analyzed the circuit to this. Okay, so in this circuit what is the philosophy? That between these two transformer anyone can take the entire load. Similar thing is applicable for this two transformer and this switchgear also. So each of the feeders are rated 100%. That means this transformer can take the entire load of this transformer. So whenever we are going for a relay coordination, we have to take the longest path. So now let us see how we are taking the longest path. See, suppose we are assuming that for worst case, only each of the incomer feeders are working. Okay, so this incomer is feeding the 132 kV bus. This transformer is out of service. So this transformer will take the entire load. This bus coupler is closed. So this is feeding this 6.6 kV switchgear. Now from here the 6.6 kV motor is running, and again we are assuming that this transformer is out of order. So this transformer will take the LT load. So see, here we are taking the longest path. That means we are considering all the breakers. Okay, all the breakers or relay, whatever you want to say, we are considering. So by this we are taking this transformer, then it is through the bus coupler, it is feeding another LT transformer, then it is coming to the 415 volts PMCC. Then again we are taking this bus coupler close. Further it is feeding the MCC through this feeder, not through this feeder, through this feeder and this small motors and this large motor. So likewise you have to find out the longest available path for each cases. Okay, suppose you have to coordinate the relays for two or three cases. Now every time you have to find out what are the longest path, possible longest path are there. Now remember one thing, here there are mainly three types of feeder. One is power feeder, that is this power feeder or this incomer feeder. The second one is the motor feeder. This one, this one, this one. Okay. And the third one is the transformer feeder, which is feeding the transformer. Now I will describe that how the relays are selected. Now selection of relay has a very important role in the relay coordination. Now see, these motor feeders are end feeder. End feeder means that the power is not going through the motor anymore. Okay, the motor is consuming all the power. So this is the last feeder of the circuit, of any circuit. Motor feeder is the last feeder of any circuit because it is not letting the power, electrical power, to transfer. So whenever there is any fault, our objective will be to eliminate the fault instantaneously. So from here we can say that for motor protection, the overcurrent and earth fault relay shall be instantaneous type. Okay, so remember, for motor protection, all the overcurrent and earth fault relay shall be instantaneous type. So these are the motor. I will connect here 50 for instantaneous overcurrent protection and 50N for instantaneous earth fault protection. Here also there will be 50 and 50N. And here also there will be 50 and 50N. Now motor also has some additional protection, but since we are discussing only about the coordination, so I am not entering to the other protection that I will discuss in my next video. Okay, so motor will be 50, motor will be protected by 50 and 50N. Okay. Now we have got that motor protection will be instantaneous. So above the motor there is the bus coupler of this MCC. So here this MCC, this bus coupler have to be coordinated with respect to these motors. So here we will use inverse time relay 51 and 51N. Okay, because this is not the end feeder, we cannot make this relay instantaneous, so we have to use here inverse time relay. Same thing is applicable for this incomer also, because we have to coordinate this incomer with respect to the bus coupler, so we will not use instantaneous relay here. Similarly, this incomer is getting fed from this switchgear panel's outgoing feeder, so here also we will use inverse time relay. Okay, this bus coupler will be also 51 51N. This incomer feeder will be also 51 51N, right? Now here there is a transformer neutral. This transformer neutral will have another 51. This is called standby earth fault relay, or 51N. Now coming to this transformer feeder, so have you understood that the motor feeder will be instantaneous 50N. After the motor feeders, all the relays will be inverse time type, right? Bus coupler of the MCC, incomer of the MCC, then outgoing feeder of this PCC, which is feeding the incomer of the MCC, then the bus coupler of the PCC and incomer of the PCC will be inverse time type. Now we will discuss about the transformer feeder. Now see, if there is a, this transformer is also an end feeder of this voltage level. See, this is 6.6 kV, and here the 6.6 kV is getting end. After the transformer, a new voltage level is starting. So a new fault level is starting. That means for a particular fault level, fault current level, the transformer feeder is also an end feeder like the motor, right? So to detect any fault up to this portion, we will make this transformer relay to operate instantaneously. So for transformer feeder, we will also give 50 for overcurrent protection and 50N for earth fault protection. Now we will give another 51, but this 51 will be used as a backup of this 51. Suppose there is any fault here, this 51 has not operated properly, then this 51 will be pick up, right? So due to this fault current, reflection of this portion fault current to the HV side, this 51 will pick up. But if there is any fault at this portion, above the transformer, then it will be operated by 50 and 50 N, right? Here also there will be 51 and 51 N. This will be also 51, 51 N. Here there will be 51 NS, and this is again a transformer feeder, so this will be also 50 and 50 N instantaneous, and here we will use 51 and 51 N, right? So these are the selection of relays for overcurrent and at fault coordination. Now important thing is selection of the time gradation, how the times will be selected. Okay, so in this video I will only show the, I have already shown the relays that are to be selected for coordination, and I will show how the time gradation will be selected. Okay, so since this is an instantaneous relay, so instantaneous means its operating time will be 0.05 second. Okay, that is the minimum time, operating time available for relay, 0.05 second. Now you let the relay of this bus coupler operated to be operated slightly higher. So let us select this operating time as 0.25 second. Okay, now select this incomer's operating time with respect to this is 0.5 second. Now you can make these two relay operate simultaneously. So this is 0.5, you can set this also as 0.5 second. You don't need to make any time gradation, because whenever this relay has operated, you can strip this breaker also. Now this bus coupler will be coordinated with respect to 0.5 second. So let's see, this is 0.75 second. Generally a delay of 0.25 second is preferable. Okay, so if this is 0.75 second, then this relay will be 1 second. Okay, now from here, this point, again our instantaneous cycle will start, right? So this will be 0.05 second. Here this will be 0.25 second. This will be 0.5 second. Here also this will be 0.05 second. And this will be 0.25 second. Now all these are relay operating times. So the entire fault clearing time will be with addition of 60 milliseconds of breaker operating time, right? So this relay operating time and breaker operating time of 60 milliseconds will give you the fault clearing time. So each of your equipment, this switchgear, busbar, this transformer, the cables, all should be capable of withstanding the fault current for this amount of time, the relay operating time and the breaker operating time. So this is the basic principle of relay coordination. You have to select the longest path, then you have to make the time gradation. Okay, so time gradations are done as I showed in this video, and whenever you have selected the time, you have to analyze the fault current, what is the fault current, and then as the video I mentioned earlier, I am giving link in the description and also in the I button, so you can check this video. By applying that technique, you can set the relay. In the next video, I will show a typical example. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video and if you have been able to learn anything from this video, please make comment, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Also, please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Thank you.